How's it going, everyone? My name is System Z, and today we are going to go ahead and build a freaking bridge. Like, this has been needed. I have been talking about doing this for so long, and I constantly say, oh, I need a bridge here. I need a bridge here. Welcome to episode part 43, I think, of the Minecraft Let's Play. We're going to be building a bridge today from here to there. Now, this is going to be a very rough bridge because I haven't already built it. This is going to be first-hand trial and error building, which you guys know whenever I do that, I don't talk that well. I always say, and I never get my point across. So prepare for that. This is another one of those episodes, but don't worry, I'm going to try and make it a little bit entertaining. But I need to ask you guys a question. This is the comment question of the day already. Oh, I thought I'd make that. That was a sad, sad, sad mistake on my part. And I'm not going to bet I get back up there. Hooray. We should build a bridge there too. I'm joking. No, that'd be a bad idea. Okay, so I'm going to try this again. There we go. Pro skills. Okay, so you see this bridge here. I'm just going to go in spectator mode. It'd probably be a lot easier. So you see this bridge here, right? Now this style is kind of representing the lodge and this kind of royal pathway type thing. As you can see, it's the same exact pattern. Just not grassy. But I'm thinking about doing that again on this side, whereas I originally thought I should do this as a wooden bridge, like one that slopes down in the middle. But now that I look at it, I feel like it needs to match on both sides. Like a wooden bridge would just throw it off because we've got stone, which is all gray and stuff. And then we have orange from the red sandstone. And then wood, brown, I just feel like it would be thrown off, like, and plus all the sand around it. I just don't feel like it would match. So what I'm going to do today is build one in this style. However, if you guys could, please let me know which one you think would be better. Whether I do another stone one or just a wooden one. And I would do both, but I don't want to be doing that. Like, I don't want to build a bridge and tear it down, because building bridges kind of sucks, because you have to pillar around a lot. But yeah, that's the kind of dilemma here. But I'm going to go ahead with a gray one. And you guys can just let me know if you'd rather have a wooden one. But we're going to run around a little bit. Actually, I got to show you guys something before we start building the bridge. Just because I know a lot of you like to watch and then, you know, usually leave if you're not entertained. So I'm going to get all the important stuff out, like, right off the bat. That way, everyone who's dedicated and the cooler fans and watchers and viewers can, you know, watch the whole thing, and they'll see. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. I forgot what I was totally talking about, and that's just one of those things. It's the trial and error building episode commentary style for me. I always, like, when I'm worried about having to build something on camera, I start babbling. Anyways, yeah, what? By the way, speaking of that, what should I call you guys? I've been having that question asked a lot in live streams. People will, like, I don't want to call you fans because, like, I just feel like that makes me sound like a, like, kind of a douchebag. Excuse my language, but I feel like fans just sounds weird because, I mean, you guys are, you know, entertained by my videos and I appreciate that, but I wouldn't call you fans. I'd call you, like, friends more than anything. So I don't know what I should call you viewers, but, how about spoons? I'm joking. You're not spoons. So I know what you're thinking right off the bat. Whoa, stop talking about how we're spoons and other bits of silverware and tell me about what this interior is. I didn't see this. You haven't done this on camera. Good question, even though it wasn't a question. I did this all on a live stream. I've been live streaming a lot lately, and I figured why not, you know, do some interior work for the live stream content. like, just to kind of give it as a treat to the people who are subscribed and know when I live stream and stuff, which, if you didn't already know, when you subscribe, you'll be notified when I go live. But yeah, so I did this kind of on live stream. Now, I'm not just going to do this whole interior on a live stream. I am going to do, the next episode, we're going to work on this area down here. But I just wanted to show you guys, like, what you're missing out on. No, I'm kidding. Now, unfortunately, I did delete the video, like, that was saved from the live stream because there was music in it and I couldn't really upload that. But, yeah, this is what we've done. I actually really like it. I'm really digging these, like, lights. And then the bookshelves. In the last episode, we actually talked about these. I feel like they complement the area so well. And I was talking about how you have to have depth when building. You can't just have a flat wall. And these pillars kind of help with that. It makes it 3D with the back wall and then these. But the bookshelves bring it out. I never really see people building bookshelves into the wall. I always see people building them into the wall as opposed to outside of the wall, like this. And I just feel like this adds so much to it. Like, it adds tons to the depth. Like, you look at this wall and it just looks complete to me. And then I added in the brick because I thought it looked good. And it still looks good, like, without the resource pack. Oh, speaking of the resource pack, I made one change. This door, I'm probably not going to keep it. I did it since, you know, I'm using a door here for now. For now, I'm eventually going to do this door, as I promised. But, yeah, it's like a little hobbit hole door. What do you think? Kind of matches everything, so. Yeah, anyways, let's never mind that. Let's go ahead and get straight into building this bridge. I have to actually get the materials to do this because, as I said, this is a trial and error free build. I have no idea what I'm going to be doing. So I've got to kind of collect myself before we do it. And yeah. By the way, guys, I just wanted to say, on the topic of live streams, if you're not already watching, make sure you do, because I've been doing a lot of stuff and raising hype for a webcam, because a lot of people have been wanting me to show my face. So that's coming soon. And if you don't already know, you can follow me on Twitter, which is in the description, or subscribe, and you'll be notified of when I go live. It's like 2, 3, 4 times a week now, so I don't really have a schedule for it, but yeah. We've been playing a lot of hardcore, too, so I know some of you guys like that. Anyways, I'm going to go ahead and get all the materials I need to get started, and we will get on straight with building the bridge. Now, I'm going to do another commercial break here, and also, you guys said it didn't work in the last one. It's not always going to show an ad. Sometimes it'll just show a little pop-up, but yeah, I feel like this is really fancy. It reminds me of B00 because he used to do that. But anyways, guys, commercial break. Here we go. Welcome back, guys. Hopefully you've gotten something to drink or you've gotten some popcorn or something, because we're going to be building the bridge now. I've got all the materials I need, kind of. I still got to do some like chopping up and stuff at the crafting bench. But as usual, I'm just checking the furnace, because you guys know I'm always throwing stuff in there and forgetting about it. okay, I actually still need to clean this out, by the way. There's so much stuff, and I really want to do something with this dragon head. Actually, speaking of that, I'm going to mention this again, hopefully, at the end of the episode, but guys, please do me a favor and start, like, sending me photos on Twitter of, like, throne designs, because that's what I'd like to do in the lab, like the main area, but I don't know the first thing about creating cool looking thrones. I don't know. But yeah, I'm in need of a lot of blocks here, so I've got to kind of chop them up, and then we'll be able to get straight into it. But how are you guys doing today? I didn't ask that, and I normally do, but I am sorry that I missed over that. It's important that I know that you guys are happy and, you know, living life to your fullest and just being a happy bunch of people. Now this is going to require vines, but I don't think I actually have any vines. Do I? They wouldn't be in there. I have like a... No, they're not going to be in there. I have... This is pretty much my foliage chest. So like, this is where I would keep them. That's why I'm looking in there. But oh no, it's getting dark. We can sleep though, because we're right by a bed. Look at that. Boom. Game doesn't even stand a chance. By the way, guys, here's just a tip. If you're living on your own right now and you've got an apartment or something and you're constantly going through drinks like Dr. Pepper and all that, and you're just constantly buying 2 liters or 12 packs or anything like that, then just stop, because you can buy like Kool-Aid, and I know I sound like a little kid, but you could buy Kool-Aid for like 20 cents a packet, and it makes a full like container of just deliciousness. And that's what I've been doing, and I've been saving a lot of money. Like I go through drinks quite a bit. I need to just drink water. I mean, I enjoy water. I don't know. I don't even know what I'm saying anymore, honestly. See, I talk too fast. That's the biggest thing in terms of why I'm not able to talk normal on the Let's Play. I'm a freak. No, but anyways, I think this, like, the water system in this apartment complex just sucks, because the water doesn't taste that good. It could be the tap specifically, but yeah. All right, this is the construction zone. And you know what I totally forgot to get? I forgot to get any wood for a crafting bench because I know I'm going to need it. Oh, great. I probably should bring a bed over here too because this is going to take longer than a day, I imagine. I'd like to aim for a shorter episode, but I mean, I just don't know. Like, building bridges, as I said, it's nearly impossible for me to do it correctly the first go. I do have a picture laid up, though, kind of a, like a work frame thing. I don't know. Work frame? What? I don't know. I'm a freak now. I don't know how to talk anymore. I don't know what words are. What is words? But yeah. Okay, so I need to get over here. This is where the chest is. I need to grab... we need a little bit of wood. I'm just going to grab a little bit, just like I said. And if we have any wool in there, that would be pretty tight. Let's see. No wool. Yes, wool. I was almost a fool there. So I'm just going to make a new bed entirely. Oh, man. I am excited for dinner, guys. I have this amazing chicken recipe right now. And I'm actually thawing out chicken right now as we speak. And I'm just excited because I learned how to cook chicken real good. Like, the best chicken you probably will ever have. And, like, I'll share the recipe one day. I might do a video on it. It's honestly not even a recipe. It's just a cooking style and seasoning mixture. But it's so delicious. Like, I've been using it in everything. Like, I've been doing chicken Alfredo with it and just plain chicken breast. I used to not even be able to eat chicken breast because I just was disgusted by it. But it turns out the people who were cooking it for me just don't know how to cook chicken. Well, not only that, don't ever buy, like, already packaged frozen chicken breast. Get it, like, right at the, like, meat counter. Like, that's... You cannot go wrong with that. Just make sure you cook it right. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. Hopefully this is not difficult at all. Alright, I'm going to get a chest just because it'd probably be easier. I already had a chest over there, but whatever. So I'm just going to lay everything out. Oh, my stomach's growling. If you hear it, then just you can laugh at it in the comments. Alright, so the first thing I'm going to do is grab these materials and going to just get started, like, simply enough. Oh, no, actually, I just realized something. I need to actually move this. I need to, like, rearrange the direction it's going because it's... Oh, God, my stomach. I might have to do, like, a break here and go eat because it's getting loud. It's getting mad. That's what's happening. It's like, feed me. And it's just not good. All right, I'm going to do that and I think just face it in that direction. Probably get rid of this one. Yeah, and then maybe I'll throw this into there just to give it that splash. And the problem with this, though, is that it's so close now to... Or it's so far away from, like, the actual edge. So it's, like, it's not going to work that well. So I need to figure this out. I may need to just bring it to the edge, which will be fine because we already have a step here anyways. So what I'll do is just kind of place these as, like, a stepping stone. Oh, wait, no, I have tons of materials in here. I can totally do it here. Sweet. All right, so I'm just going to kind of bring this out. Oh, no. I forgot about this. How am I going to do this? Just use the sand. Make some sandstone. Be cheap. Why not? And I'll do that. And again, I just have to bring this all the way up to the edge. So I'm going to figure out a good way to do this. All right. So this is extremely rough. Like, this looks terrible. I know... But I'll fix it. Like, I can do that on my own time. The bridge is what we're worrying about. So just shut up. Don't make me feel bad because I did a bad job. No, seriously, this is terrible, though. I'm totally kidding, guys. I know. You can tell me how bad I did here. This is temporary, though. I actually feel like this needs to go away. A lot of it needs to go away because I have to redo it. But, I mean, this is fine. This is a template. We can work with this. I'm just going to throw all that over there and litter all over the Minecraft world. Wrong chest. So what I'm going to do first, now that we've officially started, kind of, I'm going to grab these stone bricks. And I'm going to start by kind of laying out a pillar design. Now, I'm actually just going to copy this design over here. Actually, I can already do that. I need to grab the cobblestone walls. And I'm just going to do that, like, just like the normal design is. I'm actually going to replace these because, yeah, I mean, like, I don't need these here. Come on. I can just start the thing off right here. And then, combine the cobblestone and stuff with the sand, maybe, eventually. Alright, so cobblestone, you are up, as well as the stone slabs. I wish they just made whole blocks already of these. Alright, these are the first blocks. So, I don't know the pattern that I'm going with here. I'm just going to start by like... Oh, gosh, I need the cobblestone walls. Or not walls. Slabs first. Alright, I'm nervous. So, what I like to do with my bridges is obviously make them go at an angle, right? So, I need to figure out the best way to do that. I think I'm going to get it like that first. And then... I like to follow this design where it's two and then one back. So I need to figure out how I'm going to do that. Maybe place that there. Actually, wait a minute. No. The way it normally works is I always do that where it's two and then one, and then there's a row of four, and then you can see it's two and then one again. So if I do that again, and then... which row would it be? Should I go like all the way up? Like that's the thing about this design over here is it just goes straight up. Like it doesn't slope because it's like stone. It's not going to slope. Well, it could. I mean, it's just this is meant to look like extremely like time proof. So like just sturdy, you know what I mean? Like supposed to be a structure that cannot be broken because it's like the royal land type thing. I think what I might do then... No, it probably would be better to go up. Because we do have a lot of, like direction to go to. I don't want to go up. I guess I will, just for now. And then, so we'll do that. Yeah, alright, so how does this work? See, this is what I mean. This is why it's not fun to do this on camera. I'm just the world's worst person at it. So I need to first, I guess, do that. And then... The next row will be the four, right? Yeah, okay, cool. So now I'm gonna just bring this over here. Now, in terms of the bottom design of it, I'm just gonna do that off camera because, and I'm breaking my knees all over the place. Do I have dirt? No, I do not. So now I have to go all the way around. I've gotta fix that. That looks ugly. Get out the way, sugar cane. But yeah, whenever I'm recording and building, like especially with stuff that's organic, which you guys know by now what that means. I'm always using that word. Organic designs are like slopes and just non-normal to Minecraft type builds. And this is definitely organic, so... but I'm gonna do the under off camera because it's gonna take me forever otherwise. So this is gonna do that, right? Yeah, because I follow the same design. And then it's gonna do two and then one up, basically. So two and then one up, right? Yeah, okay. And then from there... We are going to go like that. And see, you can kind of see it's following that diagonal pattern. And it just works. So now we have to do one. And by the way, with the stone slabs, I just do that after. Like, it's a lot easier. So, yeah. It's kind of easy to just randomize it. Just like when you're doing a pathway, you always do the base block first. And then just add stuff in as you go. So now that we've done that, I think we can safely... Let's see, we got that, and then it's a two, and then one up. So, one up, just like that. And then, again, I've been doing it so much, and I don't even know how to do it. So then we'll do that. Yeah, okay, I've mastered the pattern. I totally get it now. This actually might be a lot easier than I thought it'd be. Styling it is what's going to take so long, because I'll have to, like, block around and stuff and be a freak. So, and then also the pillars. Whoa, I almost just walked into a cactus. It almost ruined my day. Whoa, that almost ruined my day too. All right, so now we'll do another one of these, four blocks across. And then what was it? It was two and then one up. I've mastered it now, check this out. Let me do that again. Nope, wrong. Let me do that. Nope, wrong. I mean, kind of, not really wrong. Then do that, and then one more time. Look at that, I'm getting it good now. I've got the pattern and we're already here. Now I need to switch to blocks. It'd be a lot easier. So, I guess we could just kind of leave it and then do that, right? Is that? Yeah, that's right. And then I would get this. And then on this block here. Nope, wrong. Okay, so I have a pattern with the pillars. I always make sure that the polished andesite is on the top. Look at me. I am doing this, and it's been a while since I've even done this, like, style. And that's the bridge. Like, that's it. Now, good. Thanks for watching. No, I'm kidding. you probably knew that. I used that joke too much. Okay. Now, I'm gonna quickly throw on the torches. Oh, I'm hearing some crazy mobs right now. They are not happy with me. So we're just gonna throw these in here. And I don't know if I already said this, but I'm totally gonna design this and like landscape it eventually. Maybe while like off camera, but I might do it 2 episodes from now. I don't know. Like I said, I've got a lot to pre-record, so I'm trying to get all these plans ahead of time. So if these next few episodes I'm not doing what I say I'm gonna do, I apologize, but you guys know the drill. I've got a lot to do right now, and I've just gotta make sure that I get it all recorded so you guys don't have no content. I guess, I don't know, in a case where I'm on vacation, do you guys think that it's better to have no content that is good quality but still a little scattered, or no content at all? And then when I return, the best content available. Like, I don't know. Oh, actually, I've got some good news to tell you guys. You guys are gonna, like, freak over this. So, I'm sure you all know that right now I do weekly videos, right? Well, whenever I move to this new apartment, I'm gonna do videos, like, 3 times a week. 2 times, 3 times, all that. And I'm not gonna have, well, no, I'll probably have a schedule for them, but I'm just gonna do them throughout the week. That way you guys don't have to wait until the next freaking week for the next episode. I always hated that I did that, but I had to do it for scheduling reasons. Okay, so I'm gonna just throw that there, and that's pretty much done. Like, maybe we'll add a few more just to randomize it up a bit more, and we'll do one there. And this is like the time consuming part. This is the part that just takes a lot of focus, and you just gotta kinda pick random spots to place it. So yeah. Now, in terms of any tips I have for building bridges, be random. And make it look weathered. I feel like weathered bridges look awesome. Because it looks like they've been through, you know, they've withstood the test of time, I guess would be the right phrase. They look like they've been through a lot. And I feel like when you do that, you feel like it looks like you have a great bridge. And I'm actually going to get rid of that because there's too much of an occurrence of that going on. There was 2 there and then 2 there. Nuh-uh. We're not doing that. That's not what we're about here. So then we'll do that and then just play around with that. And then now, the main part that we have to do is just figure out where we're going to do these pillars, because I have a pattern that I like to go with, and that's 1, 2, 3. Then we do 1 there, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Actually, what I'll do, just to make it easier, is we'll do a pillar here. So, let me do a quick check, because I think, if I'm correct, the pillars are all at the same height. No, they're not. I can totally see it. So there's always 1 block ahead. This is how it works. Just like that. 1 block above. So, and it's always polished andesite, so that's going to help us out a lot. So what we'll do is we're going to go 3 blocks from the edge. So 1, 2, 3, and then I guess right there. But I'll do it as that. And then we'll do a polished. Actually, I gotta go back over there. Dang it. Sorry, I'm always hopping around. It's not fun. But that's just the perk of building, or the perks of building a bridge. Like, I feel like it's easier to build. Oh, you know what I should have done? Built the dirt bridge first, under it. It probably would have been a lot easier. So, as you can see over here, I've got cobblestone walls, like, under each pillar. And that's, okay, that's 2 down, and then they go a block of, like, 3, right? Yeah, 3 blocks, and then all the way down to the bottom. So that should be a lot easier now that I know it. And then we'll just kind of get it all going from there. And I don't think we have much else to do. I'm actually going to lower that because I totally do not like how that looks. It needs to just be right there. There we go. And then obviously a cobblestone on top. And we're going to do that. And then cobblestone wall. And then right here is going to be, I'm just going to throw in that, right? Yeah. Okay, so then we'll do that, and then that. Cool. And then, last but not least, all the way down to the bottom. This is the part that I really like, doing the pillars, because it just adds so much to the area when you do that. It's just really cool. And now I got to go all the way up. Plus, we get to decorate how boats, like, go under it and make it look really cool. And I'll show you guys a glimpse of what I'm going to do for that, since I plan on doing it off camera. So now we're going to throw that on there and do the same thing with this side, if I can do this cleverly. So that goes there. Whoa. No, come on now. I'll just build up a little bit. There we go. And then three down. Then that, and that. Almost done. This actually went a lot better than I thought it did, or would. Turned out good. So that's two pillars. Now we just have two more to go, and we will be golden. And I need to do it on this side this time. So I'll show you guys the pattern that I've got going on with this one. Whereas over here, there's the way it worked is like, I'll show you. It's kind of hard to explain. So there's a 3-block gap here, and then in the middle, 5-block. Well, this is actually 6, but this side is 5. And then 3 again. And that's kind of the way I was doing it, but I just realized like the distance is not the same, so I'm not gonna better kind of go with that. So what I'm gonna do is, and what I've already been doing, is just going 3 from the edge and then letting however much in between kind of work itself out. So we need one here, which is gonna go, I guess there, I really did not want it to have to go like right there, but whatever. Okay, there. All the way down with the 3. And I don't like having blocks showing like the edge of it. Like I don't like it going down into things. So the way I always do it is I just like do it all the way down to the ground where the side would not be visible anymore. Just like that. So yeah. Alright. And I guess from this side we have a bridge there. And I just need to go up. Like I'm not going to better get it from here. No. Parkour. Hardcore parkour. Okay. So that was that one, right? Yeah. All right. And now we have this one. So 1, 2, 3. And then the last one will be there. And then we'll be golden. We'll be all set. There we go. And finish it off. I'm excited. Don't know how long this has taken. Sorry if this is like a really long episode already. It's hard to measure that when I'm building. So that's the like one downside to building on camera. And I like to build off camera so I can come back and show you guys, like, do a proper reveal of whatever I've built, but I think you guys probably enjoy me building on camera better. I don't know. Now, I know this is extremely rough, and I'm not going to do, you know, the fine details on camera because it's a lot harder and takes a lot of, like, pillars and stuff. Like, I've got a lot to do, like, in terms of work under it. Like, let me show you this over here. Actually, I'm going to go in spectator mode since I'm going to show you guys from above anyways. So under the bridge on this side, I have it all randomized, like looking like weight has gotten to it where it's all kind of drooping down. And I've got to do that, but that's going to be so hard to do like on camera. That would probably take me 20 minutes just to do because of the constant like dirt breaking and stuff under it. Whereas over here, you can see it's like completely flat and just wonky looking. I mean, it looks fine, but I like the design over there better. Just makes it look more sturdy, I guess. Then I've also got to do the vines and stuff. And yeah, but I think it looks good. And I've also got to fix this over here. I'm probably just going to flatten a lot of this. But overall, I think it was a good decision to go with the stone again. But let me know. Let me know if you think I should do wooden. But anyways, guys, I'm going to get everything all set up and sleep. And we'll be right back. The Patreon bells are ringing. The red capes are coming. Batman vs. Superman, I like that movie. I don't know why a lot of people didn't. Anyways, yeah, we got a Patreon, guys. Another one to add to the list. And right now, this is kind of the sketchy one that I've got going on. But with this new laboratory design that we've got building way over there, I'm going to kind of do it properly. But that's coming up soon. I might actually do that in a live stream and properly build a place for him. But for now, as usual, here is the home for him. So I'm going to get the formatting that I usually go with here. So thank you to Andre. Now, this is someone who watches live streams. I think it's Andre because that's what they said. I usually said Andre Julia, basically. So this is, I'll do that. Their channel is Andre Julia Gaming. Yeah, okay. And they did the $5 patron. And yeah, personal thank you again. I know I thank you in the live stream, but it really means a lot that you're supporting the channel, and hopefully we can get a webcam soon. And yeah, keep improving live streams. But thank you very much. Again, I'll have a garden place set for all of these soon. But yeah, so this is the Patreon wall so far. And if you guys are interested in that, there is a link completely dedicated to it in the description below. It just goes to supporting the channel. And yeah, anyways, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end off the episode here. We're going to use this as a nice backdrop because this is one of my favorite features of this world. It's just so cool and calm and collected and relaxing. Anyways, guys, I apologize for this long episode. I got carried away. Like, I even feel it now. I don't know where all this excitement came from. Like, I just feel like I was talking fast for the past 2 hours. But no, it wasn't 2 hours. It was like 30 minutes. 30 minutes already has gone by, and now I'm just racking up the minutes. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoy the longer episodes. It's really easy to fill up a long episode, and I hate that, but it's good at the same time. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. My name has been System Z. Your name has been Spoon. I'm kidding. Let me know what you want me to call you. Again, that's one of the other comment questions of the day. Anyways, guys, thumbs up are appreciated. Thanks for watching.